In the US, Democrats and Republicans often use very different language to refer to the same issues. The intent on both sides is to influence public views on these topics, but to what extent do they actually succeed? Does exposure to slanted language have a causal impact on policy views? Answering this is tricky, as cause and effect can run in both directions. People's views may be influenced by the language they see or hear, but media outlets may also slant their language to appeal to the views of their audience. This paper overcomes this challenge by exploiting an abrupt change in Associated Press guidelines. The AP is a newswire agency that distributes news to many US media outlets, and in April 2013, it banned the term illegal immigrant from its dispatches. This is a politically charged term, often used by right-leaning figures in politics and media, but the AP's ban does not appear to have been politically motivated. The organization itself is a cooperative owned by members who span the ideological spectrum, and the ban was made for consistency with a recent broader policy of not labeling people. From the perspective of disentangling these effects, the ban serves as a shock to media slant. Leveraging the fact that outlets differ in their reliance on AP copy, the author estimates the causal effect of slanted language by comparing outlets with different exposure to the AP ban and tracking the policy views of their respective readers before and after the change. To start, how did the ban affect the AP's immigration coverage? This figure shows the share of all immigration-related AP dispatches between 2009 and 2017 that used the term illegal immigrant. In a sign of near-perfect compliance with the ban, this falls from 50% before April 2013 to less than 5% immediately after. At the same time, there is no discernible change in either the total volume or tone of the AP's immigration coverage. The right panel shows that immigration sentiment as measured in AP dispatches shifts in a positive direction after the ban, but this is driven by the new absence of the word illegal. When this term is excluded from the measure entirely, there is no shift in sentiment at the time of the ban. So how did AP coverage actually change? The updated guidelines suggested substitute phrases for illegal immigrant, and while use of these increased after the ban, this magnitude is nowhere near large enough to match the 47 percentage point decline in illegal immigrant. Going further, this figure compares the pre- and post-ban frequency of words used in immigration-related AP dispatches. Illegal is a clear outlier in that its post-ban use is sharply lower than its pre-ban use, and no other word sufficiently increases in frequency after the ban to compensate for this decline. These results suggest that the ban largely led to a substitution from illegal immigrant to immigrant without direct reference to legal status, and left other dimensions of AP immigration coverage unchanged. So then, the question is how these changes diffuse into the language used by media outlets. Using text data from 2,400 print and online outlets, the author identifies articles sourced from the AP and proxies for media outlets' exposure to the ban by measuring their use of AP copy over the preceding 12 months. Comparing those with high versus low AP intensity reveals a large degree of diffusion. Outlets that source between 13 to 85% of their articles from the AP reduce their use of the term illegal immigrant by 50% after the ban, compared with outlets that don't use the AP at all. These changes occur precisely when the ban is announced, and are driven by articles sourced from the AP rather than by outlets' original content. This is consistent with a decline in illegal immigrant being linked directly to changes in the AP's language. Finally, the author compares electoral survey responses from individuals living in counties with different AP intensity of locally circulated newspapers, and she finds that the ban did affect views on immigration policy. A one standard deviation higher AP intensity of locally circulated media is associated with 0.8 percentage point lower support for increasing border security after the ban. This corresponds to 2% of the Republican-Democratic gap in support for border security, and the effect on public sentiment extends to other immigration policies, including fining firms that employ unauthorized immigrants and prohibiting immigrants' access to public services. Importantly, these effects are specific to immigration policy. The ban has no impact on other policy views, ranging from gay marriage to healthcare to economic policy, which indicates the results are not driven by a general change in political leanings. The effects are also strongest amongst self-described moderates and those living in places with a lower immigrant population. This is consistent with a persuasion mechanism. Political moderates and those with less direct exposure to immigration are likely to have weaker views that are more susceptible to media framing. And so, this paper argues that slanted language in mass media can affect public policy views. The evidence here is limited to views on immigration and exposure to one specific term, but the preponderance of slanted language in other contexts warrants further study. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on slanted language, framing effects, and the impact of media on political attitudes.